Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at the noise generator. So, let's start with the noise object. So this noise object generates a white noise sound. We can hear it by first of all, making sure we pass it through a volume control. Set the volume for that. I always like to change the range between 0 and 1 so we don't exceed volume levels. Then we go out to a digital to analog converter, left and right in stereo. We turn the volume up. You start to hear the noise. You can see on the oscilloscope and in the spectrum analyzer that we've got frequencies across the entire range and that they're varying very quickly. So it's the characteristic of white noise. Alright, so what can we do with our noise? Well, one of the things we might want to do is to control its volume so we can swell. I can do that here with the mouse. But the mouse is not super accurate, so instead I'm going to assign it to my MIDI controller. So, use control in object. I know that on my MIDI controller that my dials start from controller number 80. So in the control in, I'm going to specify controller in number 80. This number here will mean that this control object will only look at controller number 80 and ignore all other controllers. Control numbers range, like all MIDI parameters, from 0 to 127. So that's obviously too high for our volume, so we can do a simple division in order to bring it back to the range from 0 to 1, which is appropriate for our volume. And then on my MIDI controller, I can bring the sound in and out, and I've got much better control from my MIDI controller over that volume. We get this sort of swelling of sound. Another enhancement we can make to noise so it sounds a little bit more like this kind of noise we might hear in the acoustic world is to add in a filter. In this case, we're going to use a band pass filter. A band pass filter takes a range of the frequencies and rejects the frequencies which are outside of that range. With our bandpass filter, we can specify a center frequency for around which it's going to reject frequencies. And then we can also secondarily provide it with a Q, or the width of that band that's going to be let through by letting past, and the rest will be rejected. So around about 1,000 Hertz in this case, and a Q frequency. Usually this is between 0 to 10 or so in this particular patch. But you can tweak that as you like. So now my noise is going through the bandpass filter and then on. And if I turn my volume up, you can hear that we now have a much more limited frequency range for our sound. So far, so good. What often works in these circumstances is to change this center frequency. I'm going to use my controller to do that as well. So the center frequency is in Hertz. Our MIDI data comes from 0 to 127. 127 is not a very high frequency in terms of audio spectra. So I'm going to multiply that so that it brings it up into a more reasonable range. I'm going to multiply our controller values by 50 and then pass those values in and those values will now override this 1000. You will hear as I move my controller that both the volume will increase and the center frequency will increase. We're getting a much more realistic sounding noise like we might hear in nature. So this is one use of noise as a kind of continuous stream of sound, sort of like a wind noise if you like. Another use of noise is to give a very short, sharp sound. So I'm going to do a second example to demonstrate that. Again, we'll use a noise oscillator. Our basic processes will be the same. We'll have an amplification stage to control our volume and an output. What we want to do then is to control the volume of this noise, and I want to create a very short envelope, amplitude envelope for this sound. So I'm going to use the V-line object to do that. Connect that to the volume. You may recall that a V-line object needs to have a message. So we're going to go to maximum volume, volume 1. We can do that immediately. Then we're going to drop to a volume of 0. And we're going to do that in a very short amount of time. Let's say, for example, 10 milliseconds. When I click on this message box, we get that very short sound. So we've now got quite a different kind of sound than our long stream of noise. This can be the basis for sort of percussion sounds, or maybe kind of crackle sounds, like as in you'd find in a fireplace. A way which we can vary that and sort of play it and control it is to use our MIDI controller again. This time, for our MIDI input, I'm going to use the note in object. So the note in object takes key presses on the music keyboard. We know that we've got these inputs. This first leftmost input is the pitch number, but for noise, pitch doesn't really make any difference because it's just using all frequencies. Then we have the velocity or the loudness and the MIDI channel. So it's this loudness control is the one that we are most interested in as we go. We can connect that to this and play my MIDI keyboard. And that's basically triggering this amplitude every time we want it. If instead we want our note in to control, for example, the velocity, how hard we hit, then we need to do a couple of things. One is we know that this range is from 0 to 127. It didn't matter when we were just triggering the sound, but if we want to control the volume, we need to do a similar kind of division that we did over here, which is to divide that 127, that will put us into the range of 0 to 1. Then instead of always going to 1, I'm going to take the value of that input, and we do that with this $1 input. This $1 is a variable, and it takes on the value that's passed to it. So instead of being 1, it will be whatever our velocity is. Let's listen to that. That's pretty much the same, but you can possibly hear I can now control the volume of my crackles. And so that's performable. So I have my wind sound, and I have a performable crackle sound. And these are just two simple examples of how we can use the noise object to create a performable instrument. See you later.